This is module EG1311. We are team 2 from group B13, and this is project 8am. This is our designer Ryan, our programmer Shan Teng, the guardian of our robot at Wave, our cat artist Michelle, our ideator Tina, and the video editor, which is myself. We were tasked to design a robot to pass through this obstacle course. Starting at this yellow square, our robot has to overcome this 3 cm tall rectangular bump, go over this ramp, stop before this wall, and launch a ball across it. And everything has to be completed successfully within 30 seconds. Our initial idea was to try out a 3-wheel design as it would be lighter than a 4-wheel one. But after some further discussion and simple testing, we agreed to use the conventional 4-wheel model as it has higher stability and power. We determined the specifications for our design by taking multiple aspects of the obstacles into consideration. For instance, the first bump was 3 cm tall. Hence, we made wheels of radius 5 cm so that our robot could climb the bump without a significant drop in forward speed due to minimal elevation. The ramp had a smooth surface, so we added anti-slip material to the wheels for better grip. For the ball launching mechanism, we came up with two ideas. The first one is the thrower method, which is to directly use the servo arm to hurl the ball over. The second method, the slingshot cannon, uses the servo as a trigger instead to release an elastic band which shoots out the ball. In the end, we went along with the second method as it not only utilizes the elastic potential energy in the elastic band, but also ensures the ball is safely kept within the shaft as the robot traverses the bumpy obstacle course. We soon realized that this was also the key difference between the design of our robot and other teams' robots. Although both methods work perfectly fine for this task, in my opinion, the slingshot cannon just looks way more awesome. Our first prototype works similarly to a normal two-wheel drive car. It uses two wheels powered by motors to drive two other free rolling wheels. However, as you can see, our first test run was a complete failure. Our robot did not have enough power to even get over the tiny bump. We quickly learned from our mistakes and came up with a few solutions to this issue. Firstly, we added two more motors to our robot so that now each wheel is powered by one motor. Secondly, we switched the battery system from 4 parallel 1.5 volt batteries to a single 9 volt one. With these changes, we arrive at prototype 2. Now having much more power than its predecessor, nothing could stand in its way. For the slingshot cannon, we made a rectangular shaft using cardboard with longitudinal holes cut out on each side for the stick to slide along. Two rubber bands attach each end of the stick to each side of the shaft. Lastly, we attach the cannon at a suitable angle to the back of our robot, and our robot was all set for the final showdown.
Wait. 378.
Okay. 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 Let's go. It had been a really fun time working together as a team to complete this project, despite having to get up early for 8 a.m. meetings, which is also where our robot got its name. We learned a lot through the process of trial and error, and it was a really satisfying moment to see our robot clear the obstacle course during the final run.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.